Away, Townsend, South Africa 1, Renwick, Great Britain 2, Biedermann, Germany 3, Lochte, USA 4, Laveau, France 5, Fraser Holmes.
Hi Robbie, I'd like to know, what do you eat before you race?
Hi there, so your question there, what do I eat before a race? So for me, I make sure if it's race day, I'm eating three good meals a day. So I'm having a good breakfast, a good lunch, and then a good dinner. And in between those, I'm also having a wee snack as well. And then just before a race, what I like to have is like one of these energy gels, something like that. Or whether it's a banana, or whether it's just a little bit of Powerade or Lucozade, just to kind of get my sugars really, really high and firing. And then what's important is then after the race to then recover. So something like a milkshake or a recovery shake, that's absolutely spot on. But don't eat way too much. Don't fill yourself up in Haribo. That's what I used to do when I was small. And then I would have a massive sugar high, and then it came down. Just before the race, I would always have a big crash and I wouldn't end up swimming that well. So good to have a few treats here and there on race day, but just be careful you're not having too much sugar as well.
Hi Robbie, my name's Pete, BSM Master Swimmer. Question I got is, we've been on lockdown for a long while and at some stage we hope to be back in the water, but what should we concentrate on then? I've been trying to keep myself fit, but obviously that feel for the water is going to be completely gone. Just wondered what your recommendations are for when we're able to get back here. Thanks, bye.
Hi there, thanks for your question. So your question around my recommendations for what to do when you eventually do get back into the water. It's obviously very, very difficult at the moment for everyone to swim. I live in Scotland at the moment and there's no chance of people using the local pools, and the lochs and the rivers here are still way too cold. But I've been speaking to Stuart and he's saying maybe in a few weeks they might lift the lockdown, so I would recommend just getting in that sea and go for a swim. Some beautiful places you can go snorkeling and all that, so get the feel back of the water. So obviously swimming is one of those sports that you can lose the feel of the water, but that doesn't mean you can't stay fit. So whether that's staying on a spin bike, going for a run, whatever works for you, just get that fitness going. I think what's important is just to maintain your fitness throughout this. It's not really to spike your fitness. If you're a swimmer, for example, and you go on really hard and really long runs, well, all that's going to do is use muscles you've never really used properly before. That'll probably get you injured as well. So I would just stay fit, stay constant, stay active. Hopefully we're going to be out this lockdown soon, and especially as soon as the beaches open up, I would recommend get out in the sea, go for a swim.
Hi Robbie, my question is, do you ever see yourself becoming a competitive master swimmer?
Hi there, just your question around would I be a competitive master swimmer? I actually get asked this question quite a lot, and I always kind of have a similar answer. I think when I stopped swimming about 4 years ago, the last thing I wanted to do was to really jump back in the water. And for me, having been in an indoor swimming pool environment, I almost want to get away from that. So I really enjoy doing sports like football. I've been getting really into my work football team, and I think what I really enjoy about that is I'm no longer an individual sportsman. I'm working as part of a team, and I'm also doing something that I'm not very good at. So being pretty much the worst player on the football team to now being about halfway up in that football team is actually really motivating for me. It's really it's a really cool thing for me, because I feel like I'm learning, I'm progressing week by week, month by month, and I am slowly getting to be a better football player. That's just one example of one of the sports I've picked up. I'm generally just very active. Every day I'm either out on my mountain bike, walking the dog, going for a run. So don't really have that much time for swimming. But yeah, I do feel like it would be a total waste if I never swam again. And you know, maybe that would lead on to competing in a master's sense. I haven't really thought about it that much. Like I say, I really enjoy the team sports. I think having competed in swimming for 20 years, it kind of, towards the end of it, it did take the enjoyment out of swimming. So to almost jump back in as a master swimmer and be absolutely nowhere near my fastest isn't hugely motivating for me. But it is definitely something I think in the future I will pick up on.
Hi Robbie Renwick, my question for you is, do you do any rituals before a competition?
So do I do any rituals before my swimming competition? No, I actually never did any of that. So I would really kind of recommend staying away from that side of it, because I don't really believe in it, to be honest. Well, it is just my point of view. If it works for you, then that's fine. But I always made a point of not having a ritual, not being superstitious, because when you're coming to a race, whether that's at a local competition or an international competition, every swimming race is completely different. You've got a different environment, you've got different competitors, you could be in a completely different race. You can't expect to keep the same ritual the entire time, because what happens if the ritual doesn't go the way you wanted to? Does that mean you have a poor race? And we know everyone can get really nervous before races, so you know, that's one thing you might want to stay away from. What I'd recommend is just practicing your race every single day in training. You know, using your training buddies to race against, and making sure you are like almost visualizing yourself in that race and how you want to swim that race, and ultimately how you want to win that race. And that's how that's what I would recommend doing instead of having a ritual. Okay.
Is that happening often?
Recently, it's happened 3 times. So here's Robbie Renwick, the Commonwealth Champion. He was in the final in Beijing, so he's done it again here.
It's a good achievement. In fact, quite a few great Britain athletes making it through the final, and that's what you want.
Hi Robbie, I have a question for you. If you had a bad swim meet, how did you bounce back, particularly when your teammates had a great one? Thanks, take care.
Hi there. Thanks for your question about if I had a bad swim meet, how did I bounce back from that? So yeah, throughout my long swimming careers, I definitely did have bad swimming meets along the way. There were very many ups and downs throughout my swimming career. I mean, some years I swam personal bests, and some years I was quite far off, quite frankly. But for the main thing for me is, whenever I had a bad race or a bad competition, I had to understand why that was. And that sometimes meant being really quite honest with myself. So a lot of the times I had to figure out, did I have a good preparation? Was I in the right head frame? Was my training good? Was it good enough? Could I have done better? Just to kind of find the reason why I didn't swim well. And once I knew that reason, I was absolutely fine with it. I just made sure that the next competition I had, I'd make sure I was better prepared for the competition, so that these kind of mistakes, these kind of bad swims, they didn't happen as much. And of course, every single competition you go to is different, and every time your preparation, your approach to the race will be different as well. So you know, you've got to let yourself off. If you don't swim as well as you wanted, it's not the end of the world all the time. You can't just keep swimming PBs, or else we all would be world record holders right now. So it's important just to keep your head up and just understand why that didn't happen. And then next time you race, try to do better. Okay?
I've got to tell you, Robbie Renwick's looking good up in 3 for Scotland, but this is going to be really tight. Really, really tight. Robbie Renwick in 3. Is he going to get the touch? Come on, get the touch. Oh, it's gone to Robbie Renwick. Robbie Renwick of Scotland wins the men's 200 metres freestyle.
Robbie, how are you? I have a question for you. In the run-up to big swim meets, how did you deal with the pressure? I sometimes have trouble with sleeping the night before. Did you find the same? What were your strategies to deal with these kind of things and to relax you? Thank you and take care.
Hi there. What kind of strategies did I use to help me prepare for a race? I think anyone would be lying if they said, you know, on race day or the night before race day, they weren't a little bit nervous about the next day. I think that's a perfectly human thing to feel. I certainly struggled from not having as much sleep as I wanted the night before, and I was, you know, quite a lot of the time I was up just worrying. But I've kind of taken a step away from it now. There's, you know, worrying is just one of those things, is completely pointless, because you're never going to be able to change the outcome on worrying. The best thing to do is just to, you know, when you're training, is just to make sure you're as prepared as you can for race day. Prepare yourself, you know, almost visualize yourself in that race. You know exactly what you're going to do on the race. On the race day and how you're going to execute your race, so that the night before you might not be as nervous, because you should be feeling confident because you've done a really good job in training, and you're feeling confident because you know you'll get in and swim well, and it was that kind of confidence that allowed me to relax a little bit more, and that certainly helped me sleep, and it helped with the pressure on race day. And you've also got to try, I know sometimes it doesn't feel like it, but you have to try and have fun with it. Whether that's, you know, racing some of your friends from different swim meets that you don't necessarily see that often, but it's great to just catch up and see how they're doing. You know, make sure you're having fun out of every single meet you're doing, and that will keep you in there longer. And then once you do a lot of races, you'll become more and more confident, and you'll realize, you know what, there's actually nothing too much to be worried about. Racing should be fun at the end of the day. Thanks.
Hey, so I wanted to ask how it feels doing high altitude training and how much of a difference it makes while you're competing.
Hi there, thanks for your question about high altitude training. So what I would say about that, yeah, I've been to high altitude training for about 3 or 4 times in my swimming career, and I think the nature of the event, I did the 240 freestyle. I think having those extra red blood cells in your body doesn't really benefit you that much. I think if you were more long distance endurance athlete, for example, if you're a Tour de France cyclist or you're a 10K open water swimmer, I think having altitude training would be really, really beneficial for you. But for me, I didn't really see many gains at all, and very, very small gains, if that, and to be honest, they didn't last very long once you come back down to sea level. So, you know, it is an interesting way to train, but you will find that the majority of people who train at altitude are your marathon runners, your Tour de France cyclists, your really kind of extreme endurance athletes, and that's not really what I was. I was more strength and power, you know. 200 freestyle, I was done in a minute 45 seconds. So I don't think being up in altitude was very, very helpful for me. I actually preferred training, like if we would go out to Tenerife sometimes on a training camp, just being out in the sun, having the vitamin D in the sun was much more beneficial, because obviously I'm from Scotland and we don't get that here. So we'd much prefer going on a warm weather training camp.
What a fantastic swim that was! So the new Commonwealth Champion of the Men's 200 metres freestyle is Robbie Renwick of Scotland.